Everyone in the city knows this big beastie, one of the most famous structures in the city, the Finnieston Crane, except it isn't. Why? Because this is Stob Cross Quay. Finnieston Quay is over there. But we can avoid all controversy by giving it its Sunday name, which is Clyde Navigation Trustees Crane Number 7. This area has changed an awful lot. Stob Cross got its name from an old cross which had been here from at least the 16th century. Over there was a shipyard. I know this part here with the quay that we're standing on, this was built about the 1830s. Ships used to come from all over the world to load and offload right here. The big change here came in 1877 when the Queen's Dock was built. It was a massive undertaking, 34 acres in size. That is 20 full-size football pitches. It lasted until 1969 when it was filled in. What did they fill it with? Well, lots of different things. Lots of the old tenements which they knocked down at that time. The old St Enoch's railway station, a lot of that's in there. And if you're looking for the remains of Cathcart Castle, that's where you'll find it. These massive docks and quays were built because Glasgow was growing so huge on its trade and its industry. And as its industry grew, so did the things that we were exporting. And for that, you need help. Lots of it. You need cranes, big cranes, to lift big things. The first ones they had were about 50 tons they could lift. Then they went up to 75, then 100, then 130, until finally you got the biggest of them all. This, the Stob Cross Crane. Built in 1932, this big beastie could lift a humongous 175 tons. And it is huge. It's 53 metres high and the jib is 46 metres long. That's about the length of three double-decker buses. You had to be brave to operate that, especially in high winds. But what sort of stuff was it lifting? Well, Glasgow is one of the biggest shipbuilding centres in the world, so it lifted an awful lot of heavy stuff like boilers and engines into the ships which were made in the shipyards. But it's probably most famous for lifting the great steam locomotives that were made up the hill in Springburn. Over 28,000 in total, many of which were loaded onto ships at this quay by this very crane. Local people are obviously very proud of having their big local crane, but there is one downside of having such a huge metal structure as a neighbour, and that is it played havoc with television reception. It's a national monument now. It was made Category A listed in 1989. That's the equivalent of the Cathedral or Charles Rennie Mackintosh's Art School. And that's a fitting recognition and retirement for one of Glasgow's hardest working citizens. So long live the Finnieston Crane. Or should that be the Stob Cross Crane?